Now I will tell you how to find a quadratic equation if roots of the quadratic equation are given. So first of all, you know what is the general or standard form of a quadratic equation? Yes, ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, a is not equal to 0. This is ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0 under the condition a is not equal to 0 is the standard form of the quadratic equation. Its first root is alpha is equals to minus b plus root d upon 2a, and second root beta is equals to minus b minus root d upon 2a. It is very much clear that d is what? B square minus 4ac, that is the discriminant. If I ask you to find the sum of roots alpha plus beta, it is minus b plus root d upon 2a plus minus b minus root d upon 2a. The common LCM is 2a minus b plus root d minus b minus root d become minus 2b upon 2a. 2 cancel, become minus b upon a. So we say sum of roots of any quadratic equation is minus b upon a. Similar concept, same values can be utilized for finding the product of roots. Alpha into beta. This is minus b plus root d upon 2a into minus b minus root d upon 2a. When we will multiply these two components, final value will come product of roots alpha into beta is equals to c upon a. My question is that if sum of zeros and sum of roots and product of roots are given, how to find the quadratic equation? The formula for finding the quadratic equation, if roots are given, or in other words, sum of roots and product of roots are given, can be calculated by using this formula. X square minus s into x plus p is equals to 0, where s is what? S is the sum of roots. Sum of roots. And p is product of roots. Sometime we can use here a constant k also. So what is coming out to be k into x square minus sx plus p is equals to 0. S stands for sum of roots and p stands for the product of roots. So if roots are given, we can easily find their sum. If roots are given, we can easily find their product. And we can apply k into x square minus sx plus p is equals to 0 to find the equation. I am taking one example. If roots of a quadratic equation are 2 and 3, what is the quadratic equation then? If first root alpha is 2, beta is 3, sum of roots alpha plus beta 2 plus 3 5, product of roots alpha into beta 2 into 3 6. So sum of roots 5, product of roots 6. So quadratic equation become k times of x square minus sum of roots into x plus product of roots is equals to 0 become k times of x square. Sum of roots is 5, product of roots is 6. So this become minus 5x plus 6 is equals to 0. So the equation whose roots are 2 and 3 in original is x square minus 5x plus 6 is equals to 0. If a equation has its one of the 0 is 2 plus root 3. Suppose one of the root of the equation is 2 plus root 3, quadratic equation I am talking about. What is the equation? If one of the root is 2 plus root 3, then we must understand and write that is another root is conjugate of this irrational number 2 minus root 3. Now sum of roots alpha plus beta 2 plus root 3 plus 2 minus root 3 become 4. Sum of root SOR. Product of roots, that is alpha into beta. Product of roots is coming out to be alpha plus beta 2 plus root 3 into 2 minus root 3 become 4 minus 3 become 1. So equation will be k times of x square minus sum of roots, that is 4x, plus product of roots, that is 1, is equals to 0. Hence required equation is x square minus 4x plus 1 is equals to 0. There is one more very important formula to find the difference of roots. Alpha minus beta is equals to root d upon a. Sometime you can be asked to calculate the difference of roots also. Again, a is the coefficient of what? X square. And d is the discriminant, same b square minus 4ac. Sometime we can use this formula as alpha minus beta is equals to alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha betas under root. Mathematics cannot be completed by just doing or listening this much. You have to go for a rigorous practice and then you will come to notice, yes, more study, more confusion, less study, less confusion, and no study, no confusion. So my young friends, it is my advice to you that before you proceed, you have to practice more and more questions based on every chapter. To make you understand, we are taking one example that how we will solve the question by using the method of completing the square of any quadratic equation. Suppose 3x square minus 5x plus 2 is equals to 0 is any quadratic equation. But if we solve this question by using the method of completing the square, the first step is make the coefficient of x square as 1. Here the coefficient of x square is 3. So to make this coefficient as 1, we will take 3 as common. If 3 is common, then internal part become x square minus 5 by 3x plus 2 by 3 is equals to 0. Now this 3 will land in this 0. So equation is coming out to be x square minus 5 by 3x plus 2 by 3 is equals to 0 upon 3 is 0. Now find the half of the coefficient of x. The coefficient of x is minus 5 by 3. Its half will be 5 by 6. So whatever will come, the half of the coefficient of x, its square, we will write here, coefficient of x is minus 5 by 3. Half of coefficient of x is minus 5 by 6. Its square, if we find its square, its square is minus 5 by 6 whole square. Same required to add both the sides, left hand side and right hand side. So this become x square minus 5 by 3x plus square of minus 5 by 6 or 5 by 6 has the same. So we can write here plus 5 by 6 whole square or minus 5 by 6 whole square, doesn't make any effect. So this become minus 5 by 6 whole square plus 2 by 3 is equals to minus 5 by 6 whole square plus 0. Because I am adding this thing or this much result or this much means half of the coefficient of x square, that is square of the half of the coefficient of x is added in the left hand side and right hand side. By doing so, we find this much part can be written as x minus 5 by 6 whole square. एंड व्हेन 2/3 विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड दिस विल बी 25/36 माइनस 2/3 फ्रॉम वेयर 25/36 हैज कम द स्क्वायर ऑफ माइनस 5/6 नाउ वी आर गेटिंग x माइनस 5/6 होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल्स टू 36/25 - 24 बिकॉज 3 12 जा एंड 12 2 जा 24 सो द आंसर ऑफ दिस पार्ट फ्रॉम हियर आई एम पिकिंग नाउ एंड मूविंग टू दिस पॉइंट दिस इज कमिंग x माइनस 5/6 होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल्स टू 25 - 24 1 1/36 ऑन टेकिंग स्क्वायर रूट इफ वी टेक स्क्वायर रूट दिस बिकम x माइनस 5/6 होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल्स टू 1/6 होल स्क्वायर आई हैव मेड द कंप्लीट स्क्वायर सो x माइनस 5/6 इज इक्वल्स टू +/-1/6 Hence, x is equals to when 5/6 will transfer become positive 5/6 +/-1/6. So, two separate answers of x are 5/6 +/1/6 and 5/6 -/1/6. Hence, answer of x from this zone is 5/6 +/1/6 is 1 and 5/6 -/1/6 is that is 4/6 we can say simplest form 2/3 hence the solutions or roots or the values of x can be obtained by using the method of completing the square